What's up, everybody? Tyler Horvath here with another episode of The Daily Tea. It's been a while since I have posted a video. I've been super busy launching a new software as a service business called ninjareports.com. If you're interested, it's a pretty cool service for webmasters and digital agencies. It allows you to send automated reports to an unlimited amount of people for almost any online application. So currently, we have Google Analytics, Google AdWords, and Facebook ads integrated. So you can send automated reports to clients or your boss on the performance of those campaigns. So let's say you run a PPC campaign for a client and they want to know the daily traffic that it's getting and how many conversions it's getting every day, and they want to see the performance. You can set up an automated email report that will send them at a specific time, daily, weekly, monthly, whenever it may be, and they will get that report. So you don't have to keep reporting to them on how the performance is. They get that email and they see the performance of those campaigns. So if you're interested in checking it out, it's www.ninjareports.com. Currently, we have a free option that allows you to send 15 reports a month. So I would definitely check that out before we had to start charging for that. But it's a cool service for agencies looking to automate the reporting. So anyway, today I'm gonna be talking to you about keyword research. So keyword research is the very most important part about SEO. It's the very first thing that you should be doing when starting an SEO campaign. So why is keyword research so important? Well, a lot of my clients will come to me and they'll say, Tyler, I want to rank for dog collars with sparkles on them, or I want to rank for fabric buildings in Kansas City, or I want to rank for, you know, terms like that where you're kind of just guessing a keyword and wanting to rank for it that might have to do with your business. But the problem is you don't know if anyone is actually searching for that keyword. So that is why keyword research is important. You want to find keywords that people are searching for one. And for two, you want to find keywords that have user intent. So for example, if someone is searching for cars, they might just be researching cars or looking at pictures of cars. They might not actually be wanting to buy a car. So you would want to rank from keywords more like, you know, buy a car in Kansas City, or how to buy a car, or I want to buy a car, things like that, where you know that their intent is to actually purchase. So in this video, I'm going to show you some awesome techniques that I use personally to find awesome keywords that are easily rankable and can generate a lot of free traffic to your website. So we are going to move to the computer. We're going to be using a program called Ahrefs. That is one of the best keyword research tools that you can use. So I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. So let's go. Okay guys, so we are in Ahrefs and we are going to go through a few techniques that you can use to do some really great keyword research for your website. So the first technique that I have is the best technique, and it might sound a little crazy at first, but it is simply copying off somebody. So this is the best technique that you can use to do keyword research. If you are starting a business online or a website, it's highly likely that there's already someone that has created that or a similar business and they're already ranking for some good keywords. So what we're going to do is we are going to find one of our top competitors and we are going to go put them in the Site Explorer. So reportgarden.com is one of Ninja Report's competitors. So we are going to see which keywords they're ranking for and how much traffic they get from those keywords. So we can see here that they are ranking for about 20,000 organic keywords. So that will give us some great information on which keywords are doing the best for them and which ones are not. So let's click organic keywords. And here is a list of all of the keywords that they are ranking for. So let's sort this by volume. So now we can see all of the top keywords that they're ranking for and about how much traffic they get from those keywords. So if we sort by traffic, we can see which of their keywords are bringing in the most amount of traffic. So it looks like this search terms keyword is bringing this page a good amount of traffic, about 800 visitors a month. And then they get a lot of traffic from people simply searching for their brand, Report Garden. And then next you see they have this SEO reporting dashboard, which they are ranked number one for, and they get about 500 visitors a month. So next is SEO reporting tools. And this gets about 400 searches a month, and they get about 142 from being first. So This would be a good keyword to use for Ninja Reports because it is a reporting tool for SEO. So these three keywords right here would be great keywords to add to our keyword list to start trying to rank for, because you can see that the keyword difficulty is a little high for this one, but this one is about 18, which would mean we need about 18 backlinks to our website to rank for this keyword. So SEO reporting tool would probably be a keyword that we would add to our list of keywords to start ranking for. You can also just keep looking down and finding all of these keywords that you might want to rank for, and make sure that it has a good amount of volume and, you know, the traffic is there. So you can also get a little bit more in depth with the keyword. So let's say we want to see more about this keyword and who's ranking for it and how hard it will be to rank for. You can simply click on it and it'll give you some more information on this detail page. So the keyword difficulty is actually 8. So we'll need backlinks from about 9 websites to rank in the top 10 for this keyword. So now we can click view all 9 and we can see these in this list, and we can click search engine results pages and we can actually see the first 10 results for this keyword. So as we knew, we can see that reportgarden.com is the first for this keyword, and the next is agency analytics, -this.com, etc., etc. So this would be a great keyword for us to rank for because these are all of our competitors, and we can look at the backlinks and we can see which ones have the highest backlinks, and that will give us a, you know, a good idea on why they are ranking so well. So this one is ranking better and only has 11 backlinks to it, but that is because they have SEO reports in their URL, so it's a little more targeted than, you know, agencyanalytics.com. Same with, you know, dash this, etc. So this is how you do keyword research, by, you know, looking up your competitors and kind of copying off the keywords that they are already ranking for. So let's say that you don't have any visitors and you are looking for keywords to rank for. Well, it's a little harder, but it will just require a little bit of research. So you can go to the Keywords Explorer, and this is where you can look for, you know, relevant keywords for your business, and you can get search volume and see how much people are searching for these terms. So before I was talking about dog collars, so let's simply type in dog collars. Let's say that you own, you know, a dog collar e-commerce store, or, you know, maybe you sell pet supplies and you want to start ranking for dog collars. So you will search that, and this will give us a nice list of similar terms, and it'll give us a more detailed look at the difficulty of the keyword, which is about 9. So we'll need about 10 backlinks to rank for dog collars. It will give you the search volume, and it will even tell you how much is from, you know, paid and how much is from organic. So 33% of the traffic for this keyword goes to paid results. So people, you know, doing AdWords and getting traffic that way. So you can even see the cost per click on average for that keyword. So if you're wanting to do AdWords for dog collars, and then you're going to be looking at paying about $1 per click. So over here you can even see the global search volume. So it gets about 60,000 searches a month globally. So if you are selling, you know, internationally, that would be a good stat to look at. So down below here we can see the volume. So it gets about 40,000 searches a month. And now we can use this great tool here that gives us some great ideas for other keywords to use. So we can look at this list here and see the good amount of keywords. Now it's, you're gonna wanna get pretty specific with your keywords. So there's a lot of, you know, different types of keywords that you can rank for. What I like to do is search by keyword difficulty. So anything above, you know, 20 or 30 keyword difficulty is going to be really difficult to rank for. So luckily for this keyword, it seems that a lot of these are under that. So this is actually a really good keyword to use. And, you know, any number of these keywords would be great to rank for because they get a high amount of volume and the keyword difficulty is pretty low. So what you can do is you can filter keywords that have a difficulty of 0 to 10. And click apply. And now you can sort by the volume, which it already is. And now you can see keywords that are pretty simple to rank for that have a high volume. So now you can go down this list and look at these keywords and try and rank for the ones that have the lowest amount of keyword difficulty and the highest amount of volume. So leather dog collars is pretty good. That would be about 5 backlinks to rank for that, which is somewhat simple to do. And it gets 8,000 searches a month. So this would be a great business to go into right now, creating leather dog collars. So let's look at the matrix of it and let's see who's ranked for it and how many backlinks they have to be ranked for that, etc. So we can click on SERP. And now we can see who's ranked for this and some more information about that website. So we can see that Etsy is ranked the first, and this page has 0 backlinks to it. That's very surprising. Petco is next, and that has about 1 backlink to it. And then you have Amazon, hot dog collars. This one has a lot of backlinks. I'm surprised that this one is not ranked above, but that is probably because these 3 sites here are authority sites, so it's gonna be really hard to rank past Amazon and Petco, Etsy, etc. But you can see here the traffic that each one of these results get a month from it. So you can see that this one still gets about 2,100 visitors a month just for being in fourth. So you can see just being on the first page alone can really help drive some great free traffic to your website. So another important thing to remember, since we're looking at this keyword, is that it's gonna be a lot easier to rank for long tail keywords. So a long tail keyword, would be a normal keyword like this that has extra search terms on it that make it a little bit more easy to rank for. So for example, dog collars would be the normal keyword. Leather dog collars would be, technically a long tail keyword. Now you can get even longer and even longer. So you can do, black leather dog collars. You can do small black leather dog collars. It can go on and on, really. You just want to find a long tail keyword that has that short tail keyword in it, and it'll be a lot easier to rank for. Okay, let's say that you are looking to service local customers and you want to rank better for when people are searching for your business in Kansas City, et cetera, et cetera. So let's say that you have a web design company in Kansas City. So let's say web designer in Kansas City. So now we can see some local searches for people who are searching for a web designer in Kansas City. And we can see the keyword difficulty, and we can kind of see, what those people are searching for to find a web designer or, whatever your service may be in your area. So we can see that it doesn't get many searches, but we can actually use some of these links over here to get some more ideas. So we can click also rank for, and this will show us similar terms that people are searching for in order to get these results. So this could give you some more ideas of good keywords that you can rank for if no one is searching for this term. So that would be a good example of why you don't want to just pick a keyword and rank for it. So if someone were to pick the keyword web designers in Kansas City and they worked hard on getting ranked for that, it's not gonna give them much value because it only got 10 searches a month. So you can see here that it's a lot more searches for just general web design searches. So you'll have to go through and look for keywords that you can rank for in your area. So some good words that you can rank for are things like this, web designers near me, insurance companies near me, stuff like that. Now this will automatically start pulling up if you have done some local SEO. Google will look at the location and they will show them results based on where they are. So if you can get ranked using Google My Business and doing some local SEO, you will see that you will start ranking more for words like your business, near me, or whatever it may be. So that is why it's super important to do keyword research, find out which keywords people are actually searching for, which ones get traffic, and which ones don't, because you don't want to waste a ton of time ranking for keywords that no one is searching for. So those are some keyword research techniques that I use personally to rank my websites super high in Google. So I hope this video helped you on doing keyword research. Please subscribe to this channel. I'm always posting great content on SEO and digital marketing and how to grow your business online. So thanks and have a good one.